You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Wednesday, the 22nd of September, 2021, 25th week in ordinary time. And today we remember Saint Maurice and Companions Martyrs. Maurice was a native of Thebes in Lower Egypt. When he was young, he was conscripted into the Roman army together with many young people of his area and sent for military service in Switzerland. Before battle, the emperor ordered his soldiers to offer sacrifice to the Roman gods, but the Theban legion headed by Maurice refused. They remained steadfast even after being asked several times to apostatize in loyalty to the emperor. Their allegiance to Christ earned them the crown of martyrdom in the year 287. We pray for the Church of Egypt that it may remain strong through the intercessions of Saint Maurice and Companions. Let us pray. Father, we celebrate the memory of Saint Maurice and his companions who died for their faithful witness to Christ. Give us the strength to follow their example, loyal and faithful to the end. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Priscilla Isaacs, a Daily Bread member from Lusaka, Zambia.
The first reading, Our God Has Not Forsaken Us in Our Bondage, a reading from the book of Ezra, chapter 9, verses 5 to 9. At the evening sacrifice, I, Ezra, rose from my fasting with my garments and my mantle torn, and fell upon my knees, and spread out my hands to the Lord my God, saying, O my God, I am ashamed, and blush to lift my face to you, my God, for our iniquities have risen higher than our heads, and our guilt has mounted up to the heavens. From the days of our fathers to this day we have been in great guilt, and for our iniquities we, our kings and our priests, have been given into the hand of the kings of the land, to the sword, to captivity, to plundering, and to utter shame, as at this day. But now, for a brief moment, favor has been shown by the Lord our God, to leave us a remnant, and to give us a secure hold within his holy place, that our God may brighten our eyes and grant us a little reviving in our bondage. For we are bondmen, yet our God has not forsaken us in our bondage, but has extended to us his mercy before the kings of Persia, to grant us some reviving, to set up the house of our God, to repair its ruins, and to give us protection in Judea and Jerusalem. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Christopher Agbola, celebrating his priestly anniversary tomorrow, a Daily Bread member from Lagos Archdiocese in Nigeria.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 9, verse 1 to 6.
At that time, Jesus called the 12 together and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them out to preach the kingdom of God and to heal. And he said to them, take nothing for your journey, no staff, nor bag, nor bread, nor money, and do not have two tunics. And whatever house you enter, stay there, and from there depart. And wherever they do not receive you, when you leave that town, shake off the dust from your feet as a testimony against them. And they depart and went through the villages, preaching the gospel and healing everywhere. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We started going through the book of Ezra 2 days ago, and I gave the background of this book, the reason why it was written. It is post-exilic book that concentrates on the rebuilding of the temple and the restructuring of worship, consolidation of worship that was followed up to the time of Jesus. So what Ezra had established remained true to the end. It remained true up to the time of Jesus. We can see the great influence here of Ezra on the lives of the people of Israel. They came back from the exile in 538 BC. And when they came, they found things in ruins. But remember, Cyrus, king of Persia, had done a lot. He had given them permission to rebuild the temple that was destroyed, and they started the reconstruction of the temple in 538 BC with the blessings of Cyrus, king of Persia, a pagan, who helped them out. And what we see Ezra emphasizing is the fact that the temple has to be rebuilt. And he realizes that everything went wrong. The destruction of the temple happened because the people did not obey the law. They went off guard. They went off tune in terms of following the law. And with that, they had to rethink and get back to the Lord. And this is where we are now. We see the prayer of Ezra. Ezra prays. In the first reading we have today, taken from Ezra chapter 9, verse 5 to 9, we see him praying, "Oh my God, I'm ashamed and blushed to lift my face to you, my God, for our iniquities have risen higher than our heads." He's talking about the fact that things went wrong because they did wrong. And if the people of Israel do not recognize this, things will never go right. You see, the reason why people don't change is because they don't acknowledge that they have anything to change. The reason why habits don't end in life is because somebody having certain habits doesn't want to accept that those habits are there. And so we see drunkenness continuing because this person who is a drunkard doesn't want to recognize that he's a drunkard. Healing begins when a drunkard knows that I get drunk. Healing for the Israelites began when they recognized that they had sinned before the Lord. And their sinfulness, their acceptance of the sinfulness, made them gain favor before the Lord. And their worship was again seen as something worthwhile. And we want to look at the experience of Ezra and put it in our own experience right now as we face the challenge of COVID-19. We want to say, yes, we have a role to play in this. But we shouldn't be putting a blame on everybody else. Let us see, what have I contributed to making things go wrong today? It is each one of us acknowledging. Look at Ezra. Ezra takes it up upon himself and says, "I am even ashamed." We have sinned, but look, Ezra is not even the one who did wrong. No, he was born during the period of the exile. He found himself there, and he has to bear the shame of his fathers. Sometimes we have to be that responsible. We have to be that neurotic, taking up the burden even of our forefathers, taking up the burden even of other people, to say, Lord, I'm sorry even for the sins of my fathers. I'm sorry even for the sins of my great-grandparents. You know what we call intergenerational healing. Intergenerational healing occurs when you try to cut the chain of curses in your family brought about by the sins of your great-grandfathers. And you take that upon yourself and say, Lord, I ask for pardon, not only for my sins, but even the sins of my forefathers, even the sins of those who have gone before me, the sins of my ancestors. I ask pardon, Lord, not just for my sins, but even for the sins of my ancestors. And definitely the Lord is going to listen to us. Definitely the Lord is going to be attentive to us as we cry for the healing of the world today. The world will become a different place to live in if all of us decide to take a part and say, yes, Lord, I'm guilty. Yes, Lord, we are guilty. And yes, Lord, we are ready to be transformed, to be used as your children for your service. This is the message of Ezra, the message that Ezra has left for us. Tomorrow we go to Haggai. The gospel passage of today tells us of Jesus calling the 12 and sending them on a mission. And he gave them power and authority. Two words here, which to us look the same, but they are not the same in Greek. There is dunamis and exousia. Dunamis is that power, the power in you that makes you have confidence. Exousia is the commanding force over other forces, that command you have over other forces. I was chatting with somebody who was being haunted by some forces in one country I won't mention where, lest those forces try to intimidate her again. I gave her this confidence. You know, you don't have to fear what is coming to you at night, even when you are not asleep. God has given you, by virtue of that baptism, it is not in vain. God has given you two things, power and authority. You have power to command, that is exousia, and power to have confidence, that is dunamis, to have confidence that nothing will ever come to you because you have somebody in you who is greater than the one in the world. 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. Greater is the one inside you than the one in the world. And Jesus gives his apostles this authority and power, dunamis and exousia, to go and use for what? Not to show people how powerful they are, not to show people how they can boast that God has indeed fortified us. No. But to use them for service. They are meant to be used for service. He gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. They are meant to be used for service, to help other people. The power and authority God has given us is not to be used selfishly. It is not just about protecting yourself. It is also about fortifying others, giving them courage, strengthening them, making them understand that they are not going to be overcome. That is what Jesus wants to tell his apostles. And so he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal. how much we need this in our time. We need this power, this dunamis now, more than ever, when people seem to be living in fear. They have lost confidence, they have lost trust, they have lost any hope in their lives. There is no sign of dunamis. There is no sign of power in them. But we are supposed to reaffirm the power that God has given us. To reaffirm the fact that since He lives in us, nothing will come our way which He will not help to handle. We are walking with Him and walking with Him with authority and power, with exousia and dunamis. We are going to exorcise with that authority. We are going to exorcise the demon of fear in us that is making us feel paralyzed. We are going to exorcise that demon of hopelessness in us that is making many of our people even go to an extent of taking their lives, without realizing that God is still on the throne and He will always be on the throne. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Wednesday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I your bed.